Welcome back, Alex. Do you want to talk about your time in Colorado? Let's start with something positive. What did you learn from your visit to Haven Springs?
I thought I learned what it means to make a place your home.
That must have felt like quite the victory. Let's talk about how it feels to know that you might have been wrong. I suppose I'm proud of you for trying. You helped some people. Chased a mystery. Got to kiss a pretty girl. But Alex, you're right back where you started.
You're wrong. I don't belong in here.
If that were true, Alex, you'd know you were talking to an empty chair.
What the fuck? These don't belong to Dr. Lin. A tuning peg. Is that what I look like? Really? Hey, my guitar. Knock, knock. Alex Chen? My guitar case has never heard of me. Sure. Huh. I guess that's me. Case number 53322. Thrown down a... what? Thank you.
mistake. The kind of thing that you can't undo.
Alex, you know that I care about you. With everything that has happened, I just want what's best for you.
Alex.
Gabe? You're dead.
So? Lots of people are dead, Alex. Most people.
Where are we?
I want to say a hospital.
Dr. Mendez to intensive care. Dr. Mendez to intensive care.
Yep, definitely a hospital.
Gabe.
Okay, here's what I do know. You are 10, I am 14. Our mother is sick, so is our father. But it's a different kind of sickness. Play your part.
Ow! Gabe, why?
I didn't do anything.
Stop.
Both of you.
Dad.
Behave. Alex, go check on your mother.
Okay.
Thank you.
She was right over there, waiting for me. Mom used to fidget with her keys whenever she was worried.
Gabe, Alex, I need you to listen very carefully. We got some scary news today, and I'm going to be spending some time at the hospital.
What? Mom, are you okay?
Shh, hush now. It's going to be okay. Do you understand me? Things will be different for a little while. But I am going to be okay.
We couldn't afford a private room. Just got lucky, I guess. We spent so much time in here that I basically memorized every article. Gabe told me it was full of needles. Scared me to death. How many nights did Dad spend in this room? Sleeping in an uncomfortable chair and eating vending machine dinners. There's something so weird and scary about watching your dad cry. Hi, Mom. Mom. Mom.
Such a brave girl. How do you ever get so brave?
Is that how it went? You don't think you missed anything?
Ow! Gabe, why?
I didn't do anything.
Stop.
Both of you.
Dad.
Behave. Alex, go check on your mother.
Okay. Wait. Did I miss something? No matter how much Mom drank, her throat was always dry. It was always too hot in this room. Gabe and I used to watch cartoons on this thing after school. Mom, what am I missing? What did we talk about? Hi, Mom. Mom. Mom.
Water, Alex. Get her some water.
You almost never cried, even when you were very small. Did you know that? That's been my biggest challenge with you. How do you take care of someone who is already so strong? No tears, my strong girl. I want you to make me a promise. Your brother, your father, they are going to need you. You have to be strong. Will you do that, Alex? Such a brave girl. How do you ever get so brave?
Was that the last time you talked to her? Mom.
I think so.
Do you miss her?
Gabe, what's going on?
You're 11, I'm almost 15. Dad and I are time bombs. You keep running back and forth, trying to defuse us both. This is going to suck so bad. Play your part. You know that's not how it went down, right?
It was my job to keep the peace. But no matter what I did, at least I managed to hold on to you, Shushu. Gabe had barely used this backpack in weeks. Nobody could get him to go to school. Cleaning Dad's ashtray was not my favorite job in the world. Mom's old sewing kit. Don't think I've ever even tasted a butter cookie. It was full of greeting cards. Mom kept every single one we ever got. Thanks for trying, Lucky Cat.
My job was to sort them in order of how close we were to a collections notice. Almost empty. Almost always.
Hey, Gabe. I'm Leslie Halloran. I'm from the Oregon State Child Protective Services. We got a call from someone who said there might have been some kind of fight here last night. Is your dad home?
Oh, gosh. You know what? We were... Yeah, that was like, rehearsal. And I'm in this play at school, and my dad, like, he was, helping me learn my lines.
Must be some play. But if you need anything, my number is on there, okay?
K.
Gabe used to steal Dad's beer all the time. It was like the one thing they didn't fight about. I can't believe they were ever this happy. I wanted to be a werewolf that Halloween. Couldn't afford the costume. Gabe loved Son of Lead back when it was an indie. It was too gory for me.
Where are you going? Are you gonna tell her? Or is that my job?
Keep your voice down.
Fine, I'll do it. Alex, Dad lost his job again. So we're broke again.
Don't talk to me that way. Despite what you may believe, you do not know everything. You think what? I laid myself off?
It's okay. We'll figure it out.
I don't know, Dad. But what are we supposed to do now? We gotta eat.
We can sell some records. Or what about my guitar? We can sell that.
Alex, what is it gonna take to get you to stop defending him?
If your mother could see you now.
I don't wanna hear about Mom.
Gabe!
I'm so tired of you using her as an excuse to be a piece of shit. Don't fucking touch me, piece of shit!
Dad.
Damn it. Alex.
I'm okay. It's okay. It was an accident.
Alex, I didn't...
Dad. Dad, it's okay. Really. I'm not hurt.
I can't do this.
Dad?
Someone will come. That woman from CPS. Someone.
Dad.
I'm sorry.
No.
Hey, can I ask you a question? Which orphanage is this? The one in Grant Park? Kind of thought it'd be nicer.
I can't do this, okay? I can't.
You need to.
No.
You need to be honest about what you see.
I was. I have. And now I'm done.
Almost. But not yet. You were 12. I am 16. I steal a car and end up in juvie.
Gabe, come on.
Then you're 13. 14, 15. Orphanages, group homes, musty rooms in the strange houses of foster parents. By the time you're 17, you've seen them all. Somewhere along the line, you start to feel things. Your own emotions don't belong to you. You have nothing. No one. You are alone.
I don't want this.
Alex. Play your part.
Play my part. I used to write one every day. Stupid.
Why? You clearly missed him.
And I thought he missed me. Hence, stupid. Guess I missed a few days. God, they put me on so many meds.
Did any of them ever work?
Some of them helped, a little. None of them fixed me.
In their defense, mutant empathy isn't exactly in the DSM.
I don't understand. Why can't I have my guitar?
We've been over this, Alex. Your guitar stays in the rec room. You can play it during free time.
That's bullshit! I don't need it in the fucking rec room. I need it when I'm stuck in the fucking dorms.
Alex, that's enough. Maybe we'll just take away your guitar privileges entirely, if that's what you prefer.
You can't do that!
She's been through so much. I just don't know if we're prepared for a troubled girl. It says here she's sensitive. What does that mean?
She's never found a home before. I'm sure she's a sweet girl, but she's not for us.
She's awfully old, isn't she?
This is the kid that's been in all those fights, right?
I want to help. I really do, but... There's just something
off.
Broken.
Wrong. With her.
Ah!
I'm sorry.
Why?
You need to see it.
See what? That nobody picked me?
Nobody picked you. Nobody picked you. Nobody wanted you. Mom died. Dad left. I bailed. You couldn't keep us together.
It was my job to keep us...
You were 11 years old. You were 11 years old. You were a kid, Alex. Let it go. People leave. Life gets hard. Sometimes it's a big shit sandwich. Make it better. Be angry at Dad. Miss Mom. Hell, be angry at me. But don't give up. No one gets to tell you what you're worth. And no one can take your life away. Fight.
I'm not sure I...
You have a gift. It's something you don't even understand. You can change the world. Make it better. Now get up.
What?
Get up and fight.
Got to find a way out of here. No more ladder. Not that I'd be much good at climbing. Mines growing into mines, just like Jed said. I'm gonna choose not to read anything into this. I could almost laugh if it wouldn't hurt so much. How long has this stuff been down here? Oh, no. No, 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 no. No. Come on, no. No. No, no. I can do this. I can do this.
Boys, getting close.
Helldivers for life, huh, Jed?
Dig so deep, we see where the devil sleeps.
Goddamn right.
This is it. This is what Typhon tried to bury.
A lot of runoff moisture in this soil. Jed, we gotta call it. This dig is fucked.
Nothing's fucked.
Jed, we got no pumps running. No.
My teams have never quit a dig this deep before. We finish the job. Steady goes. Steady.
Fuck whistle.
Move! Come on! Clear the tunnel! Who's on radio?
Jed! Fuck! Jed! Jed!
Oh my god.
We gotta move! Now! There's still men back there! They'll drown!
Yeah, and so will we if we don't get the fuck out! Make the call, Jed!
God damn it! God damn it! Everyone, let's go! Now!
Smells like fireworks. Must be where Typhon blew the charges.
Chen, you gotta stop, man.
Chen! Fuck you, Chen! Come back!
It's over, Chen. He's not coming back.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
Huh?
And during my time here, I've come to realize what makes Haven so special. It's a flower shop run by multiple generations. A bar owner who greets every customer by name. It's a spring festival tradition going back 100 years. History, loyalty, pride. These values which define Haven are the same values that Typhon was built on. And that is why our partnership has been so successful. It's been my privilege to renew Typhon's commitment to Haven. We believe in this community, and we're tremendously excited for its future.
Thank you, Diane. I think I speak for all of us when I say we're eager to make this official. So, time to vote, folks. And then lunch.
Alex, oh my God.
I'm fine.
You are not fine. We have to get you to a doctor.
What happened to you?
Don't worry about me. I'll be okay.
Alex, you're hurt. Do you need help? We can call an ambulance.
Typhon's been lying to all of you. And so has Jed Lucan.
Alex, what's going on?
You know exactly what's going on. I was down in the mine last night. I saw what Typhon's been hiding for 12 years. Jed Lucan isn't a hero. That whole story is a lie. Jed caused the accident. And then he abandoned 7 of his men. He let them drown to save himself. There were pictures of me and Gabe down there in the dirt. Because one of those miners was my father. Typhon wanted to keep this covered up in case it jeopardized the vote. All they care about is making more money. They'll do whatever it takes to push this expansion through. So they decided to bury the evidence, and nothing was going to stop that blast. Not even the fact that there were 4 people up in the mountains. That's how Gabe was killed. Jed knew all along. He covered up the truth about the past, about Gabe. And when I found out, as you can see, he tried to kill me too. Why aren't any of you saying anything?
We don't want to embarrass you, Alex.
Try me.
These accusations are, well, they're insane. And trying to go into the mine was obviously a very dangerous, very illegal thing to do. But we all sympathize with your situation. You've been through so much. Your brother was your only family, wasn't he? I can only imagine how much you want an explanation for his loss. Something to give you comfort and make your life seem less unfair.
Why don't you just tell the truth? You've been planning your exit from Typhon anyway.
What?
You never signed up for threats or attempted murder. You hate this. Now's your chance to stop.
Dad? Do you have any idea what Alex is talking about?
No. I don't. I've tried to be there for Alex since Gabe died. I thought, I don't know, I hoped I could be something of a father figure to her. All I can guess is, sometimes when we're hurting, the people we lash out at are the ones who were trying to help.
This is an act. You're lying. Please. I know this is hard to accept. You all trust him. I did too. But I'm telling the truth.
I believe you. Of course I do. I believe you too. I'm horrified and shocked and still processing everything, but I believe you.
Miss Harmon, please remember the terms of your settlement.
Screw your settlement. I would never take that money.
I would like to speak. This young lady came to Haven as a stranger. But over the last few weeks, she's become one of us. Now, her story certainly seems unlikely, if not impossible. But she deserves at least an investigation of her claims. We ought to take her seriously.
I agree with Ducky. I've always found Alex to be a very trustworthy person. She wouldn't make these accusations lightly. Something must have happened.
Miss Laith, there's no actual evidence of anything.
Maybe not, but that's what I think.
Actually, Diane, there is evidence.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
I have a USB stick full of recordings.
Yes, we went through this yesterday. Your superiors closed the case. None of us have time for conspiracies.
Yeah. You're trying to weasel your way out of things again, huh? I know your game. I know.
Don't test me, Jason.
You know what? I'm not scared of you anymore. And not of you? Not Typhon?
All right, that's enough.
Deputy Pike, do you have some kind of personal issue with me?
Like hell I do.
Jason. Well, given that your judgment in this matter is emotionally compromised, you should probably remove yourself from...
Oh, cut the crap. If you think you could shut me up...
Jason,
with...
I think you better cool it. I would like to speak again.
It concerns me that a voting member of this council...
You believe me.
...admitted to a personal bias...
Right?
This is a load of bullshit.
I don't believe
this. Getting ridiculous.
We're all getting ahead of ourselves. And what's
I'm
the
so sorry.
Matter here?
I'm going first thing tomorrow...
Shh.
Dad, please, come clean. We'll figure it out together.
It amazes me, the extent to which she has manipulated you.
Come on, Dad.
Never in a million years.
Come on. I hate seeing you do this.
My own son.
Dad.
My own goddamn son!
Stop. I know why you tried to kill me. It's not what you tell yourself. That you thought it was best for Haven. This was never about Haven at all, was it? This was about you. I know it's easier not having to think about the men you buried. You want to look away and pretend the people you hurt aren't people. But I won't let you. My father worked for you. His name was John. He made a lot of mistakes. He wasn't a good father. I think he came here trying to be better. But you killed him. And then Gabe, my big brother. He was building a family here, doing it his own way, figuring it out as he went along. He was so nervous about it, and so excited. And he brought me here to be part of that family. But he died because of you. And then there's me. For so many years, I just wanted to survive, to get through. They even changed me. I started to think about the future. I want to belong somewhere. I want to know that there's a place and a group of people who wouldn't be the same without me. I was starting to feel that here. And you tried to murder me. You would have ended my life just so you wouldn't have to face the truth. You've forgotten it, haven't you? You've plastered over it with another story. You tell yourself you're a hero, a strong leader. Sometimes that means making hard choices. Decisions that could lead to people dying. Few men could handle that. Haven's lucky to have you. But that's the lie. If you scrape it away, what do we see? Eleven years ago, you led a group of men to their deaths. And you couldn't even say those words out loud because you're a coward. You couldn't imagine saying it to your wife, saying it in front of your son. Every day you were brave enough to go underground and look death in the eye. But you couldn't muster the courage to admit a mistake. I can feel you trying to pull away. Don't. The truth hurts. Sometimes it's so awful you think you're gonna break. But when you come out the other side, and you're whole and free and still alive, then you'll finally know how strong you really are. I see the truth about you. You hate yourself. You hate what you did in the past. You hate what you've done to keep it secret. And the more you deny that hatred, the worse it grows. I know who you are. I've seen the worst parts of you. And I forgive you.
Yeah, the silence is worse. I need to get some air. After summoning all my strength and willpower, I'm now ready to move from the bed to the rooftop.
Hey, Steph.
Alex, wait. Before you say anything, I have to get this out.
Okay.
What you did at the council meeting, it was the bravest thing I've ever seen. And it made me want to be brave too. So, here it goes. I want to be with you. I don't give a shit about playing music or seeing the world. I mean, I do, but only if it's with you. And if you'd rather stay here instead, then... fuck it. I want to stay here, too.
I've never had anyone barge in to tell me that they wanted to be with me before.
Yeah? How'd it feel?
You've, given me a lot to think about.
Well, good. That was the idea. You know where to find me. Good luck, Chen.
Thanks, Steph. All right. Just tell me.
What?
My future. What to do? The night of the Spring Fest, Steph made a strong push for leaving with her. Playing on the road. The excitement of the unknown. Of course. That was before all the shit went down. Come on, you're the know-it-all. So tell me.
Actually, I do know what you should do. You should stay in Haven.
Of course. You're right. I've never had a home before. Friends, a job, a place to live. Why would I give that up now?
Then again, maybe leaving would be better.
What?
You're young, you suddenly have a little money, friends. And don't you think it's time to give this music thing a real shot? No, you should definitely leave.
Oh, fuck off. Stop it, Gabe. I don't need the mysterious spirit bullshit right now. I just need my big brother.
I'm sorry.
I know.
But here's something. It's 3 hours from now. A bus pulls away. You're not on it. And neither is Steph. Life goes on. You get a job working with Steph at the record store. All those years of being a music snob finally pay off. And little by little, time does its thing. The apartment starts to feel less like a museum and more like a home. Thoughts of Jed, of Typhon, even of me, begin to fade into the background. rooftop is your stage. You perform every week to a small but adoring group of fans. Maybe while you play, you wonder what could have been. Performing for more people in more cities, sharing your music with the world. Or maybe you never think about that much at all. You don't know exactly when it happens, but one day you look around and find that you have transformed this place just as much as it has transformed you. And the most extraordinary thing of all is just how normal it feels. You don't question it. You don't doubt it. Or wonder what might have been. It's your life. The life you fought so hard to have. And for the first time in a long time, you just live.
Thank you.
Don't mention it.
You really think I'll transform Haven?
Of course. You already have. With your gift, your music, just by being you. But Alex, that doesn't mean you have to stay. You have the potential to do that anywhere you go.
Do what exactly? Become an actual musician?
Live in a van? Travel between dingy bars? Hawking your SoundCloud? Pouring your soul to strangers? Sounds pretty great if you ask me. The truth is, there's no telling what that version of your future might be. The only promise is the adventure. So, what do you think?
I know what I want.